Hello everyone, this is Hoda Genji and I'm here with the 10th video of the parametric design series. So far we talked about creating 2D and 3D patterns using different methods such as an attractor point, an attractor line, randomization and so on. Today we are going to use NURBS surfaces. NURBS stand for non-uniform rational basis spline. And basically, if you want to create more like a free organic surface, NURBS is the way to go. So by the end of today, we're gonna create some forms like this and this. As always, we need to start by planning the whole thing, either in your head or on a piece of paper. Think about the algorithm. In this case, I'll create the grid first. Then I'm gonna create a NURBS surface to that. Then I'm gonna move the Z vector of these points up and down randomly to create such an organic surface. Let's get back to Dynamo Revit. We had this grid before, I'm not gonna create it again. So it's on the X, Z direction. I'm gonna create a vertical surface and I'm gonna actually play with the Y direction to come up with a form like this. Now if you go to geometry, surfaces, there's an option for NURBS surface, and this is maybe the most straightforward way to create some organic surfaces. So I'm gonna try that. And as we have a set of points in here, I should probably use NURBS surface by points. So I'm gonna connect the output of the grid that we had already to points and it will create a surface for me. Next thing I wanna do is that I wanna keep the X and Z coordinates of these points, but I wanna have different Ys, okay? So I'm gonna actually move the Y direction of the points back and front, so it will give me a curved surface. For that, actually, I'm gonna move the points in the Y direction. When you type move, you don't see a move item in here, but you see translate. Translate is basically the same as move in Revit. Dynamo just knows it as translate. So I'm gonna use this option, translate. It asks for a geometry. A set of points are actually a set of geometries, so I'm gonna attach point to geometries. And for now, the X, Y, and Z translation, all three of them are set on zero, so there is no movement. As soon as assign some value to one of these three, it's gonna move the set of geometry in that direction. Right, so let me turn off this NURBS surface for a second. Okay, so now you see two sets of grids and the second one is moved in the Y direction by a value of 1. What I want to do here is that I don't want all these points to be moved by 1, but I want them to be moved with different randomized numbers. So if you type random, you remember we had random list, I'm gonna use that. And I need to create a list in order to randomize it. A list create is here. I have a 6 and an 8 direction, so I'm gonna need 8 items for the list creation. So I'm gonna go with 0 to 7. And I need to assign some values, let's go with 10, attach them to all 8 items, and if you pin this, you see that we have 80 elements here, 80 numbers, all randomized, and there are numbers between 0 and 1. Now what happens if I connect this number 2Y translation. You see the amount of moving is now different for each point. We can see it better if I turn off the first grid. We don't need it anymore. I'm gonna turn the preview off. And I want to create that NURBS surface, not from the basic grid, but from the moved or translated grid. So I'm gonna attach this geometry to points. And I need to turn on the preview. And as you see here, now we have a nice organic surface, which is the NURBS. And like before, rather than using a code block, we can go with a number slider. It will give us more flexibility. I'm gonna move it here. Maybe it could be between 8. 200 is good. I'm gonna put this on run. And I'm gonna actually delete the code block, and I have to connect that to all the 8 items. Now, if I move this back and forth, we're gonna see very different shapes based on what randomized numbers are generated. You can also change the grid size, make it bigger. Maybe I should better put this on manual, change this a little bit, run it again. You can change the size. How about I go with 1? And that's gonna make the points closer to each other, right? I can go with even a larger grid. I can change the max here, so I can go with numbers above 10. Okay, I'm gonna run it. And now if you import it as a geometry into Revit and assign some material and everything, you're gonna have something like this. You can make the distance between the points very small. You should be careful because it might crash anytime when it gets too detailed. And if you want the surface to be like a bit less ragged like this, you can again use a divider and divide these numbers by some bigger number. I might go with 2, 3 or something, put it here, and attach this number to the translation amount. If this number goes larger and run it here, you see it's now softer and more fluid than before. So this could be part of your facade design, part of the walls in your interior design. You could do this for different surfaces, whether it's part of your walls or even the ceiling or any other thing you can think about. As a final step, I'm gonna import it, import by geometries. Even if it's only one geometry, like in this case, in my experience, import by geometries works a bit better in Revit, so I'm gonna use import by geometries. I'm gonna connect this to that, run it, and now we have it in Revit. And as you remember, it's a very great idea to have your Revit on meters. I'm gonna save and close Dynamo. Now it's good in Revit. All I need to do is to save this Revit file somewhere. And this is like week 4 of this course, okay. And as you remember, there are some ghosts of the previous objects created out of Dynamo that are not there anymore. So I'm gonna close the Revit file. Okay, yes. And then I'm gonna open it again. No more ghosts of any objects there anymore. Okay, and this is one single object. I can go to Manage, Object Styles, imported objects, and it's actually this one. I'm gonna change the material. You can go with some plastic, wood, anything you can think of.